Hello, my name is Lena and this is my colleague Chris. Today I will show you the commissioning of a standard pH glass sensor with integrated reference element, gel electrolyte and built-in temperature sensor. A good example of this Memosens CPS11E with Memosens digital technology. This sensor type is easy to handle and needs no external KCL supply.
Lousy and rainy weather today, but the commissioning can only be done on site because it's an analog pH transmitter. Hopefully, I will not get any problems with wet or humid cable connectors. I have to go. See you later.
Thanks to my pH sensor with Memosens technology, there are no problems with water or humidity. A potential matching is not necessary and the calibration can be done in the lab. All calibration data and sensor information are stored directly in the sensor itself. Please remember, always wear your personal safety equipment before you start to work. Your chemical resistant gloves, your safety glasses, and a coat. Now let me guide you through the commissioning of a CPS11E sensor. All pH sensors with Memosens technology are factory calibrated. Calibration is only required if strict accuracy requirements must be met or if the sensor has been in storage for longer than 3 months. If this is the case, I will show you how to perform your calibration in the lab. Use an instrument with Memosens technology and Memosens cable like the Liquiline CM44. Connect the sensor and open the calibration menu. Press the soft key Cal, select the right channel, choose and confirm two-point calibration with the navigator, and confirm the start of calibration with OK. Put the sensor in the first buffer solution requested from the CM44. By default, pH 7. Wait around 1 minute to let the sensor settle. Confirm with OK. The instrument waits now for a stable measurement value. If this is given, the value is taken over automatically. Check the display raw value. For a buffer with pH 7, it should be around 0 millivolt plus minus 15 millivolt for a new pH sensor. If OK, rinse the sensor with clean water. Then put the sensor in the second buffer solution requested from the CM44. By default, it's pH 4. Wait around 1 minute. Confirm second buffer with OK. The instrument waits for a stable measurement value again. If this is given, the value is taken over automatically. Check the display draw value. For a buffer with pH 4, it should be around 177 millivolt plus minus 15 millivolt. The sensor slope should be between 55 and 60.5. If so, adjust the sensor by pressing OK 2 times and return to the measuring screen by pressing Escape for 3 seconds. The calibration data is now stored in the sensor. Now rinse the sensor with distilled water. Fill the protective cap with KCL solution. And put it on the sensor. Then place the sensor in its original packaging to protect the sensor during storage and transport. The advantages for you are immediate correct measurement as soon as the sensor is connected to a transmitter with Memosens technology, no on-site calibration, just plug and play, no moisture problems thanks to the Memosens plug, and no interference potential and potential matching due to the complete galvanic isolation of the sensor and the transmitter. For the second step, you have to go on site. Take the sensor and remove the KCL cap. mount it into its assembly and connect the Memosens measuring cable to the sensor. The handling of the assembly depends on the assembly type. Follow the installation according to the operating instruction of the used assembly. Do not mount the sensor upside down. The angle of inclination must be at least 15 degrees from the horizontal. If you need an upside down installation, please contact your local salesperson. Restart the process and check for leakages. Check the on-site measuring instrument for a correct pH and temperature readings. That's it. Thanks to the Memosens technology, the commissioning was really easy. The calibration data is stored non-volatile in the sensor head, and there's no on-site calibration necessary. Thanks for watching this video. Follow our channel to see more of our productions.